So if I had a superpower, it would be to understand where someone is coming from. So a bit of an ability to look back into their memory so that I can understand a little bit more about maybe their response and why they've responded to a question a certain way, in order to help them better understand the context of whatever I'm trying to teach them about. So my name is Chaz Heck, and I'm a Nawagi Bidra Mamu woman, and I'm a registered pharmacist who's currently practicing as a pharmacist at Logan Hospital, but have been working with the Indigenous Health Strategy Group at the Australian Pharmacy Council for a number of years now. What I see as really important for me at the moment is to make sure that Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander pharmacy students who are studying see themselves in the course content so that they have a sense of belonging. I almost didn't become a pharmacist because everything looked very different for me, and I think that's absolutely essential to have more pharmacy graduates delivering culturally safe care. One way that we can get more Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander pharmacy students into the programs is being really cognizant about the various different pathways that people might enter university programs, reaching into high schools, making sure that scholarship opportunities and mentorship opportunities are really well embedded, and people might need actually that one-on-one approach and be encouraged to apply. Again, sometimes that might be really meaningful for someone to be approached individually rather than just by an email, say, for example. When we're talking about Aboriginal pharmacy students seeing themselves within a course, it's really important to think about how we reference and talk about Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people within the course content. We want to be celebrating strengths. No one wants to learn about what they're meant to be like, particularly if it's based in a deficit. We want to be celebrating strengths and celebrating the oldest continually surviving culture on this planet, who have been using traditional medicines and have been healing through ice ages for tens of thousands of years too. An example of a strengths-based approach might be, say for example, how Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people are so well connected in their communities. I think our health system at times is probably lacking a little bit like that. And I think what makes a really great pharmacist is someone who knows their local healthcare ecosystem, who can connect that person to, say, other allied health, or perhaps give them supports in other ways. I think it's that interconnectedness of Aboriginal culture that can really benefit the wider healthcare system as a whole. I see LIPPE being a really valuable asset to be able to share knowledges so that we're not starting from the beginning every single time. I'd love the LIPPE Network to be a place where both knowledge holders and learners can connect together to improve Indigenous health outcomes. Join LIPPE.
That was good.
You've got the silliness coming out, Anna.